Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of Trevor and Sophia in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church, and Holy Scripture commands it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. And when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Sophia Marie Reeder and Trevor Allen York now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. Sophia and Trevor, I require and charge you both here in the presence of God, that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage, lawfully and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. And now, Sophia, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Trevor, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon Sophia and Trevor, who come to you seeking your blessing and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the reading.
Listen to the reading from the letter of Paul to the Colossians. Therefore, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, for just as the Lord has forgiven you, so that you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, praises, and hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Singing of the gospel hymn.
Thank you.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you." The Gospel of the Lord. Sophia and Trevor, please come forward. And you may be seated. We will now continue with a marriage vows. I'm going to start with Trevor. Thank you. Trevor, will you please take Sophia's right hand in yours and repeat after me? In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Trevor. Take you, Sophia.
Take you, Sophia.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Now will you please loose hands, and now I'm going to invite Sophia to please hold Trevor's right hand into yours and repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Sophia. Take you, Trevor. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Amen. And now I'm going to invite Trevor and Sophia to exchange their own wedding vows. And thank you all for your help.
Trevor, I have to catch my breath to believe this is real, that I am marrying my true love, my best friend. 3 years ago, you summoned magic into my life, and everyday sex has been a treasure. You are so kind, patient, intelligent, and compassionate. You see the good in the world and inspire me to be the best that I can be and to work to help make the world a better place. I promise to be your lover, companion, and friend, your ally in conflict, your greatest fan, and your toughest adversary at board games. Your comrade in adventure, your consolation in disappointment, and your accomplice in mischief. I choose you, today and always. I accept and love you as you are, and offer myself in return. Together, we will create a home filled with learning, laughter, and compassion. I will care for you, stand beside you, and share with you all of life's adversities and all of its joys, from this day forward and all the days of our lives.
My dearest Sophia, today, as I stand before you, surrounded by our loved ones, I am overwhelmed with your gratitude and love. I am overwhelmed with gratitude and love for the incredible woman that you are. You have taught me invaluable lessons about the power of love, and the strength that lies within the union of two souls. With respect, trust, and open communication, I have discovered a strength I didn't know that I needed, and a joy.
You're doing great. Just breathe a little bit. It's fine.
Today and every day forward, I choose to spend the rest of my life with you. I promise to cherish every moment we share, embracing the laughter, the tears, and everything in between. I will hold your hand through life's ups and downs, offering unwavering support and a shoulder to lean on. In times of joy, I will be your biggest cheerleader, celebrating your triumphs with unbridled enthusiasm. In times of sorrow, I will be your comforting refuge, providing solace and understanding. When doubt creeps in, I will be there to remind you of your incredible strength, your unique talents, and the boundless potential that resides within you. I will offer a listening ear and the unwavering belief that you are capable of achieving greatness. Your dreams are my dreams, and even though they may take us to uncharted waters, I will be there supporting you every step of the way. Sophia, I give you this solemn promise to love you fiercely, passionately, and wholeheartedly. With you, I have found my forever home, my sanctuary of love and belonging. Together, we will create a lifetime of beautiful memories and navigate life's journey hand in hand. You are my everything, and I am honored to be your partner for all eternity.
Are you sure I can't kiss him now?
Yes. Let's make an exemption. Or you can wait. No, you can make an exemption. This was more powerful than 10 sermons, so yes. Okay.
With all the love in my heart.
It takes a lot of strength, love, and vulnerability to share such beautiful vows. Let's give them a round of applause. Just don't make me cry because I have to perform this wedding. Okay. After this beautiful moment, we now continue with the blessing and exchange of rings. Bless, O Lord, these rings to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Trevor, as you place Sophia's ring in her finger, please repeat after me. Sophia,
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And Sophia, also please repeat after me. Trevor, I give you this ring.
Trevor, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. You can finish putting the ring in. And I'm going to join your hands. I just need two for now. Two of your hands at this moment. Let me do this right. Now that Sophia and Trevor have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Trevor, you can now kiss your wife. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my true honor to introduce, for the first time, Trevor and Sophia York. Please stand and join me in the prayers, which you can find on page number 6 of your service bulletin. And your way to participate in these prayers is to say an enthusiastic amen after each prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world that you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon Trevor and Sophia, whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony.
Amen.
Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy.
Amen.
Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their life.
Amen.
Give them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours.
Amen.
Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to this sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy conquer despair.
Amen.
Bestow on them, if it is your will, the gift and heritage of children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you.
Amen.
Give them such fulfillment of their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others.
Amen.
Grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed.
Amen.
Grant that the bonds of our common humanity, by which all your children are united one to another, and the living to the dead, may be so transformed by your grace that your will may be done on earth as it is in heaven, where, O Father, with your Son and Holy Spirit, you live and reign in perfect unity now and forever.
Amen.
Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, poured out the abundance of your blessing upon Trevor and Sophia. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle upon their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come, have life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Also.
You can exchange it, the peace, and you can kiss again. God's peace be with you. You're doing great. Thank you. God's peace. Peace be with you. You may now be seated for a moment. Welcome to Christ Church, and thank you on behalf of Sophia and Trevor for being here to celebrate and witness to their love, which is a blessing, actually, for each one of us in this room. We will now continue with Holy Communion, and it is our tradition in the Episcopal Church to have an open table, so you are all invited to join us for communion. That doesn't mean you have to. That means you're welcome to. If you would like a blessing, just cross your arms across your chest, and when you come to the rail, I can give you a blessing. If you want gluten-free wafers, we have them too. This service is truly for Sophia and Trevor, but also for all of you, and we just want to let you know that you are all welcome in this place. Our ushers will guide you for communion when you come forward. Amen.
Make his face shine upon you. Be great.
Please stand as you're able and join me on page number 7. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because in the love of wife and husband, you have given us an image of the heavenly Jerusalem, adorned as a bride for her bridegroom, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who loves her and gave himself for her, that he might make the whole creation new. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
And now we pray together, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. The gifts of God for the people of God. Everyone is welcome to the Lord's table. Amen.
To God and to the Lamb I will sing, I will sing. To God and to the Lamb I will sing. And when from death I'm free, as is the great I am, while millions join the theme, I will sing, I will sing.
Please join me on page 12. Let us pray. O God, the giver of all that is true and lovely and gracious, we give you thanks for binding us together in these holy mysteries of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that by your Holy Spirit, Sophia and Trevor, now joined in holy matrimony, may become one in heart and soul, live in fidelity and peace, and obtain those eternal joys prepared for all who love you, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Please stand. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.